This morning I am still entranced by the image, distance, and dim of that awe-inspiring landscape such as no mortal ever saw. Sleep is full of miracles, obeying a curious whim I had banned from that spectacle. Painter proud of his genius, I savored my picture, the delightful monotony of water, marble, and metal, babble of arcades and stairwells. It was a palace infinite, full of basins and of cascades, falling dull or burnished gold, and heavy waterfalls like curtains of crystal, or hanging bright and resplendent from ramparts of metal. Not with trees, but with colonnades, the sleeping ponds were encircled. In these mirrors, huge naiads admired themselves like women. Streams of blue water flowed along between rose and green embankments, stretching away millions of leagues toward the end of the universe. There were undescribable stones and magic waves. There were enormous glaciers bedazzled by everything they reflected. Insistent and taciturn, Ganges in the ferment poured out the treasure of their urns into the chasms made of diamonds. Architect of my fairyland, whenever it pleased me, I made a vanquished ocean flow into the tunnel of jewels. And all, even the color black, seemed polished, bright, iridescent. Liquid enchased its own glory in the crystallized rays of light. Moreover, no star, no glimmer of sun, even at the sky's rim, illuminated these marbles that burn with a personal fire. This morning I am still entranced by the image, distance, and dim of the awe-inspiring landscape such as no mortal ever saw.